Electric motors are everywhere. Motors convert electrical power to mechanical power. Fleming's left hand rule decides which way coil will rotate. To understand the working of the motor, we will take the square loop of coated copper wire. Bottle cap holds a square loop in place. It also acts as a commutator. How they are built, we will see later. Loop can be circular as well. To understand schematic in a textbook, square loop is better. North pole is marked by a white chalk. Direction of magnetic field is from north to south pole. When a potential difference of 6 volt is applied, the motor starts. For our analysis, the right side is marked AB, while the left side is marked CD. Sides marked in blue are parallel to the direction of magnetic field. These sides do not play any role in the rotation of the coil. Let us understand how direction of rotation is decided. At this particular instance, let us consider AB part of the loop. Direction of magnetic field is from your right to left. Direction of current is towards you. As per left hand rule, force on the side AB should be downwards. For the CD part of the loop, the direction of current is away from it. Direction of magnetic field is from your right to left. As per Fleming's left hand rule, the side CD should move upward. This results in clockwise movement of the coil. When the coil rotates halfway, AB and CD switch positions. At the same time, commutator ensures that the direction of current is same. Coil continues its clockwise movement. It is also called a split ring. It is split at two places, which are perpendicular to the coil. Copper wire loop acts like a carbon brush. For the same direction of current, the direction of rotation changes when direction of magnetic field is changed. Let us see construction of rectangular coil, copper loop and commutator. Rectangular coil with 100 turns is wound with the help of 4 needles attached to the plastic container. Here copper wire is used for commutator. Caps at these two places ensure that they are separate. Copper wire loops ensure that there is always a contact between moving parts, just like carbon brushes in actual DC motors. This is how current flows through the DC motor. Do try these variations as well. Thank you.